Good morning, St. Louis. Happy Monday. I'm your co-host, Brittany Kyles. Thanks for joining Studio STL. Tim is on vacation. Question for you. Have you ever went to a movie that was really interesting and then decided, I gotta look more of this up online? Well, we got the perfect match for you. Jurassic World Rebirth comes out July 2nd. And what better way to learn more about fossils and dinosaurs than to have a few experts in the studio? Okay, first up, Megan Linton with the St. Louis Science Center. How you doing?
I'm good, how are you?
Great, and then on your right, we got Stegosaurus Steve, with owner of the St. Louis Dinosaur.
Hi, guys.
Absolutely. We gotta introduce our other friends here. We got Iggy. The T-Rex, and who was this?
Oh, this is Baby. She's the, don't be shy now.
Oh.
She is the newest addition to our, don't lick the screen, I tell you. She's thirsty. We've been waiting here under the lights for a while. She's the newest addition to the St. Louis Dinosaur Stable of Live Dinosaurs. Anytime you need a live dinosaur, just go to stlewisdinosaur.com.
She's so cute. Hi, Baby. Nice to meet you. Okay, Megan. We got Jurassic World coming out this week.
Mm-hmm.
So this is a good opportunity for people to learn about dinosaurs. How can they do so with the Science Center?
So we are super lucky that we have our own paleo prep lab. So on certain days of the week, we'll have volunteers come in and they will actively work on fossils. People can interact with real life fossils that we've actually dug up. And other days during the week, education staff actually will come out and we'll, you know, have different dinosaur related activities. And you know, you can touch real fossils, real dinosaur poop. You can get all of the information.
Real dinosaur poop.
Uh-oh.
Coprolite,
yes.
Mm-hmm. How does that smell?
Like a rock.
Oh, okay. I thought it smelled like something else. Well, that's good, I guess. Okay, so as far as like the different types of dinosaurs on mm-hmm. display, tell me about that.
So at the Science Center, a lot of our fossils, they're going to be Triceratops or Hadrosaur, because that's just where we like to look for our fossils in that area is what's popular. We have some T-Rex. My personal favorite, which is not a real dinosaur, unfortunately, we do have some Mosasaur fossils. We also have Velociraptor and some sauropods, which are going to be your long-neck dinosaurs.
That is so cool. Okay, so we're bridging pop culture and science education. That is so cool. Stegosaurus Steve, where do you come in as far as Jurassic World? What are some of the things that are real that they did in the movie that you could tell us about?
Well, we all know that dinosaurs eat people.
That is very true.
So they got that right.
Okay.
But Iggy's done. He's a vegetarian.
Oh, so, good.
Yeah.
You know, we got some vegetables out in the fridge, Iggy. We got you covered.
That's right. He won't. He's harmless. Yeah.
Okay, so the Jurassic Park franchise portrays how dinosaurs were created. Could you tell us exactly how they did that? And is it true what they had in there?
So, based on real science, from what they did is they extracted some DNA from a mosquito uh-huh. trapped in amber.
Uh-huh.
There are insects trapped in amber, and we have actually sequenced DNA from them.
Mm-hmm.
Not quite like how they did it in the Jurassic Park franchise, unfortunately.
Uh-huh.
We're able to get some DNA, but it's mainly from the insect that's trapped inside that amber.
How about the soft tissue they're finding now in Triceratops horns?
So
like that?
We need to that's do more what, research for our part of that, but that is something really cool that we get to look into.
It is. That's what we use to reanimate Iggy with, although he's not a Triceratops. they are genetically related, and that's how he came back to life.
So I got a question. Have you guys, of course, seen all the other Jurassic Park movies?
I unfortunately have not. I have some catching up to do.
Okay, well, this will be a good opportunity this week. But of course, you, Steve, right?
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah. So question for you.
Yes, ma'am.
If we were to bring dinosaurs back at this day and time, would that be a good idea?
Depends on what dinosaurs you're bringing back.
What about Iggy? The vegetarian.
Oh. Well, that's the point. He's a baby. He's only 3.5 years old.
Yeah.
And he's a vegetarian, so he makes quite the house pet. He does eat a lot of
house
vegetables,
pet.
Though.
What kind of cage would you get him?
Well, he roams free in the backyard.
Okay, that's good. Okay, we got some merch over here for people. Tell me about that, Steve.
Oh, is that your merch?
It might be, but I'm not 100% sure.
Well, we got survival kit, Jurassic Park. Well, it comes out this week. Comes out this week if you guys are interested in seeing it. And how can people go to the St. Louis Science Center if they want to learn more about fossils?
So you are always welcome to go to our website, check out what we've got going on. But more than likely, if you just want to walk on in, we're totally able to sit there and assist with anyone, talk with you about all the fossils you want to talk about.
Woody, right?
And Woody, yeah. Our wonderful volunteer Woody, who's there on certain days of the week. He's great. We love him. We love all of our volunteers.
You can watch him work on his fossils right there while he's cleaning them up and restoring them.
Stegosaur Steve, thank you guys so much. Megan, thank you guys so much.
Thank you.
Go see Jurassic World in theaters this week, Wednesday, July 2nd. We're going to have more Studio STL when we return.